What's up guys, welcome back for another DevPro Duel video. Finally, last match here in the Cross Balance Cup, the top 16 at least. Two very big decks in this game's history, one of the more recent decks here in the Cross Balance Cup. So both Satellites pretty much at full force versus Burning Abyss. Last match, top 16. First, the deck list, Satellites pretty much at full force, triple Rota and 21 traps. Helmet dot deck, no disrespect intended, but it's crazy. Like playing against 21 traps is definitely not fun, for me at least. Then the second deck list, Burning Abyss, also pretty much at full force. For me, the most important power cards are in the deck list. Two or three Fire Lake, in this case, three Fire Lake, triple Emptiness, triple Dante, triple Tour Guide, and the list goes on. Which deck has the advantage? Well, for me, I think Burning Abyss. In general, Burning Abyss should be considered to be the better deck. But yeah, Satellites. 21 traps, double breakthrough skill, that Chaos Trample in the main deck, that Constellar Factor, Stellar Nova. That's it, the counter trap for Satellites. And also the Mind Crush, not to forget, Triple Fiendish Chain, and Diamond in the extra deck. So yeah, it's not completely going to be a walkover for Burning Abyss, but the match still has to be played, so let's hop into the first game. Alright, first duel, I think I get to start. Yeah, I'm playing Satellites, my opponent is playing with Burning Abyss, so the pre-opening of 5 rule. I get to start, 6 cards, and why not immediately set up, a Pujin Tsukuyomi, and I think send Deneb to the grave with that Unukai, and of course, immediately flip over Call of the Haunted during my opponent's turn, because I think I have two Stellar Nova Alpha sets, and I think I had to activate one on the Night Beam to protect the second one, and immediately Chaos Trapple, that one copy Chaos Trapple coming through, definitely coming through here, banishing the Dante, and now I'm in an excellent position. Normal summon Altair, he has no response, very cool, and again, get two draws with Pujin Tsukuyomi. I decide to attack into the phase. Yeah, we knew it was a Skarm, Book of Moon, and then try to use Castell to bounce back the Skarm, since again, I'm in a very good position. I should be in a very good position. He decides to go for Fire Lake, although I think he could have expected that Stellar Nova Alpha, because again, I used Call of the Haunted during my opponent's draw phase, I believe, but I don't think there was anything he could do here. I'm not really sure. He also should have attacked first before using Altair to get a little bit, I think 100 more damage. But in the end, it's not going to matter that, into Diamond. It's just crazy. Yeah, Triver. That was the name I was looking for. Triver, such crazy card with all of the continuous traps, Call of the Haunted Oasis, finishing to just reuse them. Anyway, Burning Abyss got to start, so they have the advantage here with Triple Tour Guide into Dante. Such an easy card to get those rank 3 plays going. Dante, sir, so we can expect a possible Fire Lake here, but he does use Emptiness. Luckily, I do have an out in the form of Raigeki, but that Emptiness definitely slowed me down. It's not looking too great. He uses his Phoenix Swimming Blast to bounce back the Oasis, I believe. Yeah, immediately flip over Typhoon. Randomity, I think indeed that was the better play here to open those rank 3 exceed plays. I have to break through skill the Tour Guide. I kind of expected here. He can expect either an Unuk or a Deneb in my hand, since he used Emptiness earlier on the Vega and dropping the BLS here. I think I definitely would have done the same. He has a Tour Guide search in the end phase, and I think one back row, and I think it's a Fire Lake. Indeed, it's a Fire Lake. So I think he definitely could have risked the BLS here. But it's not going to matter. He uses his Dante for Sir searching for Skarm, but Skarm is destroyed due to BLS to get a search in the end phase, and no reason to reveal the set card. Last tool, important tool, which deck is going to move on? I get to start, and this is an excellent hand. I have two options. Either I can just search Deneb, and or search that Unukai. Unukai search setting up the Deneb in my grave, and but I think I went for what is it called Deneb to search out an altar to set up altar in my grave, so I could have reborn it during my opponent's turn with Oasis, I think, or call. No, it's Oasis. Yeah, and it kind of backfires here with a Mystical Space Typhoon, but by doing that, by searching out altar, I was able to keep the breakthrough skill earlier, and I think that was a better move, since we know his deck does run three tour guides, so having at least one breakthrough skill for that is kind of crucial, right? And I do have a lot of top decks, double altar still in the deck, multiple calls, multiple oasis, and I have the opportunity to go for a possible Dagusto Emerald to get the pack those altars. Anyway. Here, very unfortunate for him, I think he drew one of his serfs. He reveals one to special summon it, Mindcrush coming through, calling the Sir, and again, very unfortunate for him, he reveals the second copy of Sir, and now during my turn, I can just attack for a game. Yeah, so nothing really he could do, but it was an excellent match. Burning Abyss, don't take this one. So Satellite Knights go on to the top 8 and will take on Shadals in the top 8 for a spot in the semi-finals. Guys, that's it. Thanks for watching, and feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Legion signing out. Peace.